So hello everybody, I am back with a question that I was wondering because I built both of these. What's better, the brick built machine gun or the brick arms machine gun? Brick built one you get the instructions for in the Great War Volume 1, and the brick arms one you can buy on Brickmania, anywhere where you get your brick arms from. This one is the one that came with the Allied crate in World War 1, or not the Allied, the Entente, the Triple Entente. Great World War One pack, and it has a couple different things like white links, which is more accurate, so the 303 machine gun belts, like the fabric they're made of, because that would imply that it was brass all the way through, which no ammo link has been made like that, or belt, not to my knowledge at least. And it comes with this silver tripod, which I don't know if that's more accurate or not. I think it is. Then again, I don't know how accurate the black all the way through color is, but this is the basic one. So for argument's sake, this is what we're comparing, but you could easily make it this one. Yeah, we'll just keep this one here because it's got the guy on it. This is from the Brickmania Great War Volume 1. I just threw it together tonight, and honestly, if you have parts around, it doesn't take too long, like a half an hour to find the parts. Most of them are very easy, and this one definitely looks better in the barrel as like an air-cooled machine gun. Or not air, water-cooled machine gun. Let me see if I can just focus it in there. Yeah. Whereas to this one is much like rounder, almost looking like an MG08, which there's also a brick-built MG08. That one's just not that good, frankly. But this is one of the better brick-built machine guns because of the... I don't know what this is. I think this is a battery, but I don't know why it'd be a battery because if it's an open-bolt submachine... Or not submachine gun, machine gun... Or closed bolt. I forgot exactly. Yeah, it fires from the closed bolt. Either way, someone's gonna know. Closed or open bolt machine gun. It wouldn't need a battery pack to operate it because it should just be operating on recoil and the way the springs work and push the shell out. Anyways, so I think this is water. I don't know exactly. I'm pretty sure it's water. But I like the way it looks. I don't even know what it is, and I like the way it looks. And, for firearms of the World War I period, I usually know a lot about those, or at least I would like to think I do. But, nonetheless, I like the way this looks, and personally, they both look good to me in different ways. This one's probably more realistic, but this, there's just some charm it has to it. Anyways, that's my video. So, if you want this, just buy it for $6. If you want this, just buy the Great War book. The instruction books are already a good deal, and compared to the digital instructions, which are $10 an instruction flat rate for either you're buying, building a railway gun, a fighter jet, or just a fighter plane, it's $10, or $15 if it's really big. But, it's kind of the same thing. It's, a lot cheaper to buy these books because they come with like 30 or 40, not 30, they come with like 20 models usually. To build instructions for, so price per model will be roughly $5, where half that of the books, but they're not making books anymore. Well, they're printing books, but they're not making new books. They're just selling sticker packs. And I want to touch on this because I know someone's going to say something. This back stuff here, this is just German cavalry, that's not what I'm talking about. Villa Perosa, I already have a video on that. This is the MG08 sled mount. I made this a few months back, and it's not bad. I like the way it came out. But this is what I'm really proud of. The Earnhardt EV1. Now, I'm curious to see if Brickmania will be accepting kits, because this is roughly within their scale I tried to build it in. But I just built it for my own purposes, so if I were to sell it to a company or something else, I mean, you can look up the real thing. It's the Earnhardt EV1, as I said. I tried to make it as faithful to the real thing as possible. It's got a you go in here, it's got a, I just snapped that off, it's actually pretty, you know, interior, it's got a whole bunch of other stuff. If you want to see a whole video on it, just comment that, and we'll certainly do that. And as I said before, Villa Perosa was that. This is completely my design, no one else's design. Villa Perosa, there was this brick journal thing, or something like that, maybe I'll link it. Good guys there. Help me if you, well, they didn't personally help me, but they have some good instrument models there sometimes, if you want inspiration. I think that's kind of the whole point of the website. But I assume they want credit for the Villa Perosa, so I don't want to steal their design. But anyways, I'm going on for long now. If you'd like to like this video, please leave it a like. If you'd like to subscribe to this channel, I don't know why. I mean, you should talk to your doctor about that. You might have some brain damage, but anyways, have a good day, everyone.